Good morning, everyone, and welcome back to Battered Arenas with Doc Stout. I am Doc Stout, and we're in a fresh arena run here. I talked a little bit last time in the Frostmage edition about how my goal for this series is to have 10 different arena decks with each of the heroes, and we have no choice at all here because I've already done Shaman and Mage, which means that Malfurion Stormrage, I choose you.
I must protect the wild.
All right. I played a little bit of Druid. Abomination, Ravenholt Assassin, or Mana Addict. Man, I don't like any of these very much. I guess the Abomination is... because, I don't know, Mana Addict could be fine in a ramp deck, but it's just for one turn. Ravenholt Assassin is okay. I mean, I want something to impact a little bit bigger for seven. I guess we'll just take our first Taunter. Maybe I'm wrong. Maybe Assassin's an awesome card. Keeper of the Grove is either a silencer or does two damage when he comes into play. 2-4 for four. Starfall is five damage to one or two damage to all. Nourish is two mana crystals or three cards. It's actually a difficult choice because I kind of like all of these effects. I like drawing cards. I like wiping the board. I like silencing troublesome minions. I think I'm going to have to go for the removal, though. Spectral Knight's cool. Iron Beak Owl's nice. I don't like Raid Leader. That's the only one I'm not going to choose for sure. I've already got two cards that cost five, so Iron Beak Owl gets in the deck. I am unenthused by the other two cards, so Harvest Golem it is. Yep, Sengen Shield Master. It's a good taunter. Good value. Light Warden or Secret Keeper, they both have conditional ways of getting bigger. Or I could just take the Nourish I passed on before. 3-3 for 3 that has a cool Enrage, I think is better than the other two cards. 3-3 for 3 that gives me a sweet battle cry seems fine. Yeah. Frost Elemental. Yeah. I mean, I like Harvest Golem. I don't know if I need another one, though. Man, my 5-drop slot is getting clogged, but I don't think I can not take Stampeding Kodo. I need some cheaper stuff, but I don't like Imp Master. Either a Sludge Vulture or a Sunwalker. Both have conditional ways of making extra stuff. Sunwalker costs one more, loses less value when silenced. Has one more power. 5-drop slots clogged anyway. Like that Mad Bomber, what bombs at midnight? Have an Earthen Ring. Unstable Ghoul. I guess I'll try a Loot Hoarder. Ugh, I love Murlocs, but not in this... not in Arena. Soul of the Forest seems sweet. Good anti-weapon card. Just a workhorse card here. Wild Growth, Naturalize, Innervate. I'll take the Innervate. Iron Bark Protector at the top. Azure Drake for sure. That one's not even difficult. Swipe or Starfire? I'll go with another swipe. Wrath or Strangle Thorn Tiger. It's going to be Wrath because 5-drop slot is clogged. Mark of Nature or Flesh. I think I'll go Flesh Eating Ghoul. Demolisher Emperor Cobra is a winner. Dark Scale Healer seems obvious. The only guy who doesn't have one toughness, even though it's another 5-drop. Really don't like one toughness guys in Arena. Frost Elementals are always good. I guess I'll take card draw. Not excited about any of that. I have enough taunters. I could use more silencers. Ooh, this presents me with an interesting choice. I can get another silencer, or I can try to make use of my own silencers, which I only have a couple of, to allow the Ancient Watcher to attack. That's pretty narrow, so I think I'm just going to take the Keeper of the Grove, but it was worth thinking about. All right, we've got our deck. I am not in the text chat this morning. I think I'm just going to take this thing out with a spin and then call it. After the first game, one way or another. I'm not thrilled about the deck, but it's fine. It's got some things I like. Some cards to silence, a nice amount of defense, a little card draw, a little removal. Potentially some mass removal and some nice synergies. Certainly played with worse decks. We start off with a mirror. Druid on Druid action.
Nature will rise against you.
Well, let's see if we can't get more early game things, because I don't think either of those are blowout enough to ramp into. Ask and ye shall receive. I don't think any of them are powerful enough to waste my innervate, though. See if he's got a turn one play. Like a nice 4-drop off the top of the deck. Light the fire. What are we playing? We're playing the coin. We playing something that gives me... Yes. We're playing a potential... Let's try for the 2-for-1. Nope! He decided to just punch me in my face. Thanks, Mad Bomber. That was bad luck. That is the downside of playing that card, though. I have to use the Earthen Ring Farseer just to undo the damage the Mad Bomber caused to me. That's frickin' awesome. Come on, bud. Not choosing a college. Yes, Actually not sure what my next play should be. I'm tempted to... Okay. It's fine. That makes this pretty obvious. Kinda wish... Well, that's at least gonna force him to do that. Kind of wish I had one more mana. Oh, you're going to Flesh Eating Ghoul. That's freaking great. Okay. Hopefully I can find hard removal for it. Otherwise, I'll just have to kill it. And that sucks. Now, what are we gonna do? Okay. That's fine. Well, that's not good. Okay, let's play like this, I guess.
My eyes are open. For the wild.
Get in our first point of pseudo damage. No, I don't like this at all. I still got some value, but I'm down on cards. No, that thing's just gonna hit me. I could kill it, I guess. Alright, yeah, let's get a little bit of advantage on the health track. That way I can actually use my Stampeding Kodo for value. Best he can do is take this thing out, which I'm not sure he's going to want to do, unless he's got hard removal. My board position's pretty sweet now. No, don't Defender of Argus. Don't Defender of Argus.
The Frost Wolves stand ready.
I don't mind so much about that. I guess I will have to draw three cards. What is his base? He's a 4-4 base, so silencing him doesn't actually do very much. Let's get the Loot Hoarder out. Just crack in a little bit. I guess that's okay. Two or less attack. Now mine doesn't do anything. I could double swipe. I could double swipe his face. Let's see, that's 8. 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. That's not quite enough. He's got 9. I could make it 8 with the silence. Three, five. Yeah, let's do that. Take away some of that. And just try and double swipe his face for the win. If he gains life, pretty much hosed, or I guess he could just play something and kill me. This way, if it gets worse, I at least have the option of using the swipe on the Frostwolf Warlord. You're gonna Defender of Argus, aren't you?
I must safeguard the lab.
You want to silence that? Okay. I think you did that in the wrong order, but fine. Oh, buddy. Oh, buddy. You're not going to be happy with me. Swipe your face. Swipe your face. It's not exactly how I intended to use my pseudo board wipe, but it works. It's direct damage to the dome. And, alright. We actually win the first round of our mirror match. And, yeah. So far, this makes this the second most successful deck in Battered Arena history. That's not saying much for my record so far. Join me again. If you're watching live, it'll be after the weekend. If you're watching on YouTube, it'll just be tomorrow, where I will take another run at this. Until next time, I'd like to thank everyone for watching, whether live or after the fact. And this is Doc Stout with Battered Arena, and I am signing out.